is with you. What it is that surprises me is that I don't really want you to. And your shoulders are frozen. Oh, you're an explosion. Your name is a real.
Thanks very much for coming along.
Thank you.
How was it waking up on Sunday morning as another Heineken Cup champion again?
Ah, it was amazing. I mean, the atmosphere over there was kind of something I've never experienced before, and obviously with the two Irish teams in the final, it was just a really special occasion, and thankfully, you know, we've done three in a row.
Did you have any inkling in 2008 that you're going to come over and in the next 4 years win three Heineken Cups?
Not at all, really, you know. I didn't really know how important the competition was until we won it that first year, and I can still see Shaggy and Dricko celebrating after the final whistle, after the first win, and you know, that was something special, and I think everyone sort of remembers that and wants more of that feeling, and I've just been lucky to be here since that day. So I wasn't here for the heartache before, but I've been here for the good times, and I think that's something Leinster's created and something that they sort of want to drive for the future as well.
When you said that when you came in as a 19-year-old and you were helped out by the older players, was that advice off the pitch? Was it sticking up for you on the pitch? How did it actually work?
It was a bit of both. I remember my first game was against Loud, and one of the first balls I got a penalty, and I remember their fullback. I was only talking to Peter Fitzpatrick today about it. I got the knees of the fullback into the ribs, and I remember starting to roar, and Charlie coming over and says, "Get up! Never let them see your hurt. Never let them see your hurt." So that was kind of a bit of advice I took from there on in. So
he didn't exactly stick up for you. He just told you to get up off the ground.
Pretty much.
Yeah, good old Charlie.
But no, it was great to have kind of experienced guys over there, because in those days, I suppose, backs kind of got away with a lot more than they do nowadays. So in those days, I was told, if a back goes near you, just put your hands up. And anytime I had someone like the likes of Colm Coyle, I always used to kind of make my way over to the hill, because I always felt safe standing in front of the hill, because if he started at me, I knew there was about 10,000 doves that were itching to get on and do a job on him.
Darren, let's talk about you. You qualified for the Olympic Games. It seems a long time ago now. Yeah. How have you found the last few months?
Yeah, it's been interesting, definitely. You know, obviously the Olympic Games were a dream for me, but last October that came true, and it's probably changed my mind frame a little bit, and I've had to change it since. You know, obviously we're all delighted at home, but I suppose I got to concentrate a little bit more on development, my boxing skills through the last few months. You know, but in recent times then I found out I need to get back to the level I was at. So I've been working hard lately, and you know, things have been going well in the gym, and we're training very hard, and with a few fights coming up, which is going to be, you know, get to test ourselves there. It's been great, really. You know, although the training is killer tough, I've enjoyed the experience, and everyone at home, and you know, the atmosphere around it it's great, really.
I'm going to ask you both, Richie, will we get through the group?
I hope so.
That's a no from Richard Sadler there. John Giles, final word to you as always.
I think we're capable of getting out of it.
So again, no.
When I look at, don't forget it's predictions, we're trying to look in the future. Yeah. But all you can say with any match, no matter who it is, whether it be Ireland or anybody else, are you capable of winning? They're capable of winning, and it depends then what they do when they're there. We can talk until we're blue in the face here before we go away, but it depends what the players do and how they play in these particular matches. But if they play well, I think they're capable of doing it. But it's a difficult task.
Sounds good to me. John Giles and Richard Sadler, everybody.